Welcome back. We got another cool little tutorial. We're going to show you how to paint these fences to look like wood. Let me turn my focus. Come on, you. There we go. So we're starting with some black plastic fencing. It was black plastic, and then I primed it with just a black flat spray paint. So we're going to take it from this to this wood look. I didn't do the back yet. I'll do the back another time. I just want to show you how I achieve my wood grain look here with just acrylic paints. So we'll do it on this smaller section right here. Before we get started, make sure you love this crusty old sign. This is like the most beat up old subscribe sign. We're going with it until it falls apart. Hit subscribe, hit that bell button, so that way you get notifications every time we do a new video. And if you enjoyed this, give us a thumbs up. So what we're going to do, we're going to dry brush all of these layers on. And the paints that we're using for this range from dark, which is a Deco Art Bittersweet Chocolate. We're going to use a Steel Gray from Folk Art. Dark Tape or Taupe, whatever, however the hell you say it, from Craftsmart. Light Tape or Taupe. I don't know how to say that. It's some French word. from Craftsmart. And Folk Art Boulder. We're going to put them in our palette like that. Nasty, crusty palette. And then I'm just going to dry brush. So over here, you'll see on the sides some of the remnants of my dry brushing from my first round. And so for this, I'm going to use just a rough bristle, a coarse brush. There's the brand, cheap-ass brand. So to start, we're just going to do a heavier brushing of the dark brown, the bittersweet chocolate from Americana. Just going to give it a good old base coat. It's not really dry brushing for this first layer, but it's not very thorough. It's okay if a little bit of black is showing through. I'm fine with that, especially in the cracks of the wood. Okay, and we're just going to hit it with the hairdryer. Nice and dry, real quick. The next layer, this is really any order you want to go in. There's no right or wrong way to do this. This layer, we will do more of a dry brush though. So I'm actually going to use I think I missed a paint when I was going over this with you guys. Where's it at? Uh-oh. Hang on, I'll come right back. I did. I missed a paint. So this is another one that we're going to use. I forgot to announce it earlier. It's Honeycomb by Americana. I'm sorry, Folk Art. So anyways, we got a little bit on our brush. Get some of the paint out of the brush so we can dry brush. And then we're just going to lightly add some color to it. Some areas are going to be darker. Some areas are going to be lighter. That's okay. And I want to go the same direction. I always want to go up and down. I think it's okay to go up or down, but you don't ever want to go side to side because it's not the way our wood grain is going to go. Make sure I get the posts there. I'm just hitting the post real quick. Not doing side to side on the boards. Okay. I'm going to wash out my brush and do the next color. Okay, for color number 3, we're going to go with the light, like khaki color here. Taupe. I think it's called Taupe. We're going to go with Taupe. And same method. We're just trying to hit a little bit of coverage on each color. That way we can see the other colors showing through. So now you can see the three different colors. Come on, focus on it. You can see the three different colors in there. You can see the dark brown, some blacks, and you can see the two other browns we've used already. And as we do more, there'll be more diversity in color. All right, the next color we're going to paint with is going to be the dark taupe. Kind of a grayed out, dull color. I'm hitting this with the hairdryer in between. You guys know what I'm doing. I don't have to do that every single time. I'm just drying it with a hairdryer in between rounds. Okay, there we go. Okay, so now that it's got a lot of similar colors, we're going to use two grays. The grays will kind of lighten that fence up. It's starting to look a little washed out. The color is starting to look pretty similar. So I'm going to get a little bit of my steel gray and add some like whiter light gray highlights to it. Remembering to still go in the same direction every time. Okay. Let's do the other gray, which is our boulder. I think it was called boulder. Yep. It's a little lighter of a gray. So now we got some browns and grays. All right, and for the last layer, I'm going to go through with the, what was this one here? The light taupe. I think that's what that one was. I'm going to get a different brush, though. This one's pretty wet, so I'm going to get a drier brush. Hit this with just some really light brown accents, just to bring that brown back out. And then I think for fun, we're going to add a little bit of the chocolate color again and see what that looks like. Just a tiny bit. We want this to be very light dry brushing. Oh, let me hit it with the hairdryer. Okay. There we go. I'm satisfied with that. And there we go. There is my wood fence. It went from black plastic like this to a really cool worn wood fence color. Obviously, you can paint these white if you want it to be a white fence, like a picket white picket fence, or the fence was whitewashed. It's not a picket fence, but you know what I mean. So we went from black to a nice weathered fence. It creates a pretty cool effect. And we're going to be putting it on the layout here now. But thanks again for joining. As always, subscribe, hit that bell button. I could make a graphic for this, I think, but I like this old beat up. It's got paint on it. It's got water drops. We're going to use this one. Subscribe, hit that bell on that button, and give us a big old thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Thanks again. Later.